Dear students, welcome to EPG Pathshala. I am Professor P. Bhaskar Reddy, Department of Ancient Indian History, Culture and Archaeology, Sri Venkateswara University, Tirupati. In the present module of the paper Outlines of Indian History, you are going to learn about two dynasties of South India, the Pallavas and Chalukyas. The Pallavas and Chalukyas, who rose to prominence in the middle of 6th century AD, they played a key role in political as well as cultural history of the South. The learning objectives of the module are the political institutions of South after the Sangama and Satavahana ages, to know about the background for the rise of the Pallavas. Then it proceeds to know about the origin and early history of the Pallavas, the political history of the Pallavas, and to know about the important achievements of the rulers Mahendravarman the First, Narasimhavarman the First, and Narasimhavarman the Second, also known as Rajasimha. Then it followed the next dynasty, Chalukyas of Badami. In that, you are also going to learn about the origin and early history of the Chalukyas, political history of the Chalukyas of Badami, achievements of the Pulakesin II and their contribution to Indian culture. With these objectives, let us start the topic with a brief introduction to know about the political developments that took place in South India after the fall of Satavahanas and Sangamajas up to the rise of Pallavas and Chalukyas. It is known that the period from 3rd century Christian era marks the second historical phase in the history of the south of the Vindhyas. It is known that in the first phase, it is the ascendancy of the Satavahanas in Deccan with Pratisthanapura as their capital and Sangamage kingdoms in extreme south Tamil Nadu region. The second phase, from 3rd century to 6th century Christian era, there arose many kingdoms, nearly dozen states ruled over different parts of Deccan with independent powers. Among that, the Satavahanas were succeeded by the Vakatakas in Maharashtra and Vidarbha. Their political history is important to Northern India than South India because they have a matrimonial and a diplomatic relations with the Guptas. But culturally, the Vakataka kingdom became a channel for transmitting the Aryan ideals and social institutions to the South. After the decline of the Vakatakas, the Vakataka power was followed by the Chalukyas of Badami. The eastern part of the Satavahana kingdom, that is in the Krishna Valley, they were succeeded by the Ichwakus. The Ichwakus, as a successor of the Satavahanas, they played a key role in political as well as cultural history of the Deccan. Their monuments were found in various parts of Andhra country at Amaravati, Nagarjunakonda, which attracted international importance in those days. The Ichwakus were supplanted by the early Pallavas. The important contemporary rulers of the Pallavas at the time were the Kadambas of Banavasi, Gangas of Mysore, Shalankayanas of Vengi, Vishnukundins of Indrapura, Kalabras of Tamil Nadu. With this political uncertainty, by the middle of 6th century Christian era, the Pallavas of Kanchi, the Chalukyas of Badami, and the Pandyas of Madurai emerged as three major states. After the emergence of Chalukyas of Badami and Pallavas, the main interest in the political history of South India from 6th to 8th century centers around the long struggle between the Pallavas and the Chalukyas. The Pandyas, who were in control of Madurai, joined in this conflict as third force. With this background, now let us start to know about the political history of the Pallavas and their contribution to Indian culture. The Pallavas were one of the important dynasty which rose to prominence in the middle of the 6th century AD, but the origin and the early history of Pallavas is also essential to understand how they rose to importance. The origin of the Pallavas became a debatable topic among the scholars. Many views expressed regarding the origin and early history of the Pallavas. Among that, B.L. Rice was the first scholar who identified the Pallavas with Pahlavas or Parthians of ancient India. Some scholars thought that the Pahlavas were descended on one side from the Cholas and on the other from the Naga rulers of Jaffna. K.P. Jaiswal, another scholar, argues that the Pahlavas belongs to the clan of Vakatakas because both of the dynasties belong to same Gotra. S.K. Iyengar, another historian, states that the Pahlavas were family of feudatories of the Shatavahanas. He argued that the Pahlavas has migrated to Tamil country from the southern parts of Shatavahana Empire because the early Pahlavas from 3rd century BCE to up to the rise of Simha Vishnu in the 6th century Christian century, their inscriptions were found only in the part of Andhra region. It is thus evident that the Pahlavas were the rulers of Andhra region, and later they extended their sway over Tandamandalam, and by making Kanchi as their capital, they became prominent as Pahlavas of Kanchi. Regarding the early Pahlavas, the Pahlavas rose to power during the later part of the Ichwaku rule. Simhavarma, who was the earliest family member of this dynasty, established Pallava rule in coastal Andhra by defeating the Ichwakus. Sivaskandavarman, another ruler, seems to be the greatest of the early Pallavas. His dominions extended from Krishna to South Pennar and up to Ballari district. He had the title of Dharma Maharaja and performed Vedic sacrifices. This indicates that during the time of Sivaskandavarma, they assumed imperial status even in beginning of 4th century. Vishnugopa was the next important ruler. It is known that during the time of Vishnugopa, when he was ruling as a Yuvaraja, Samudragupta invaded at that time and the Pallavas suffered disturbance because of that invasion. Later on, taking advantage of that situation, King Karikala of Chola dynasty invaded the Pallava kingdom in the middle of 4th century AD under the leadership of Trilochana Pallava. There are several rulers which were mentioned in the Prakrut as well as Sanskrit inscriptions up to the rise of Simha Vishnu. Nandivarma was the last of the early Pallava kings. During his time, the Pallava kingdom experienced the invasions of Kalabras. Thus, for a short period, the Pallavas lost their political importance, and once again, they rose to importance from the time of Simha Vishnu. From the time of Simha Vishnu, it is known that the Pallavas are called as Imperial Pallavas. Simha Vishnu was the first ruler of this line. He has credited with many achievements. He defeated the Kalabras and the laid foundation for the establishment of the age of the Imperial Pallavas. He also defeated the rulers of Chola, Pandya and Chera kingdoms. He became the master of entire region between the river Krishna and Kaveri with his conquests. Regarding his achievements, he was the worshipper of Vishnu and had the title of Avanesimha, that is, Lion of the Earth. According to the literary tradition, a great poet, Bharavi, visited his court. That shows from the time of Simha Vishnu, they contributed for the growth of literature. Simha Vishnu was succeeded by Mahendra Varman I, who ruled in between 590 to 630. He was the greatest ruler and versatile genius. He was not only a soldier and statesman, but also a religious reformer, an architect, a poet, and musician. He assumed several titles like Mattavilasa, Chitrakarapuli, Vichitra Chitra, Gunabhadra, and Lalitakura. All this says the valorous of this King Mahendra Varman I. During his time, politically, a long-drawn Pallava Chalukya conflict began. It was during the time of Mahendra Varman I, the great Chalukyan ruler Pulakeshin II invaded over Kanchi. A great battle was occurred between Mahendra Varman and Pulakeshin II, where in that war, Mahendra Varman suffered defeat, and as a result, Pulakeshin II almost reached the Pallava capital, but peace was concluded between two dynasties and many of the northern portions were taken over by Pulakeshin II. This was the beginning of the Pallava Chalukya conflict where it continued for another 2 centuries. Mahendra Varman, regarding the achievements of Mahendra Varman, he was the follower of Jainism but later converted to Shaivism under the influence of Thirunavukkarasu. He was the author of the Sanskrit work Matta Vilasa Prahasanam. He was also a great builder of cave temples. Rock cut caves at Mandagapattu, Dalavanuru and Tiruchirappalli were excavated. He also promoted the art of painting. The Jaina paintings were found in the rock cut caves at Chittanavasal. He had the title of Chitrakarapalli, which it reveals his talents in music. The next important ruler of Pallava dynasty is Narasimha Varman the first, who ruled in between 630 to 668. Narasimha Varman was the greatest king and administrator and great warrior. During his time, he raised the power and prestige of the dynasty to an amazing height. He had the title of Mamalla, which means a great wrestler. During his time, once again, the Pallava Chalukya conflict started and it was successfully continued by Narasimha Varman the first. He wanted to take revenge the defeat of his father at the hands of Pulakesin the second. Thus, during the time of Narasimha Varman the first, he successfully defeated the Chalukyan ruler Pulakesin the second in 3 battles. Later, he killed. Narasimha Varman assumed the title Vatapikonda, which means he is the conqueror of Vatapi, the capital of the Badami Chalukyas. The notable achievement is his naval expedition to Sri Lanka to reinstate the Sinhalese princess Mana Varman. During his time, the Chinese pilgrim Huyen Sang visited the Pallava capital Kanchi. According to his account, the people of Kanchi estimated great learning and Gatika of Kanchi served as prominent center of learning. He was also a great builder, constructed Mamallapuram and also erected the monolithic radhas, which were the magnificent constructions of the period. Narasimha Varman was followed by Mahendra Varman II, who ruled in between 668 to 670. He ruled only a short period of 2 years. He was killed by Chalukyan King Vikramaditya the first. Once again, Chalukyas dominated over the Pallavas and Vikramaditya captured Kanchi and ruled for it for a short period. With this defeat, once again Pallavas suffered political disturbance because of Vikramaditya the first invasion. Parameswar Varman was the next important king who ruled in between 670 to 690. Once again the Pallava Chola conflict continued during his time. After many reverses, Parameswar Varman the first finally won a decisive victory over the Chalukyas and their ally the Gangas. He was called Ugradanda and that means the destroyer of the city of Ranarasika. It is known that Ranarasika was the title of Vikramaditya the first. Regarding his achievements, he was a great devotee of Shiva and built Shiva temple near Kurram, Kanchi. The next important ruler of this family is Narasimha Varman the second, also known as Rajasimha, who became familiar both in political and cultural history of Pallavas. He enjoyed a peaceful reign and credited with the construction of the great Shore temple at Mamallapuram and also the beautiful and magnificent temple Kailasanatha at Kanchi. He was also a great patron of art and letters. The famous Sanskrit scholar Dandini is said to have adorned his court. He also sent embassies to China for the promotion of maritime trade. Have a look at the magnificent Shore temple and also Kailasanatha temple Kanchi. After Narasimha Varman the second, Parameswar Varman the second ruled in between 728 to 31. Again, the Pallava kingdom had to face defeat and humiliation. Vikramaditya the second attacked Kanchipuram. The Pallava king had to buy a peace once again. Later on, Parameswar Varman the second was killed in a war with the Ganga king, an ally of the Chalukyas. With the death of Parameswar Varman the second, the Simha Vishnu line of Pallava kings came to an end. After the death of Parameswar Varman, a mild war of succession was started in between various branches of Pallavas. Nandi Varman, Pallava Malla, who belonged to a collateral branch of the Pallavas, became the king. During his time also, the renewal of conflict between the Pallavas and Chalukyas occurred. Vikramaditya II invaded the Pallava kingdom and defeated Nandi Varman and captured once again Kanchi. Regarding his achievements, Nandivarman was a worshipper of Vishnu and a great patron of learning. The celebrated Vaishnava saint Tirumagai Alvar was his contemporary. Since the time of Simha Vishnu, the Pallavas dominated the destinies of South India with capital H Kanchi, and in their conflict the Pallavas scored many victories. At the same time, the period is interesting where the entire 200 years of history, it is a conflict between the Pallavas and Chalukyas of Badami. It resulted for the declining of the Pallavas. Now, regarding the decline and end of the Pallava rule, Vikramaditya II's attack and the temporary occupation of Kanchi may be regarded as the beginning of the end of Pallava supremacy over South India. Later on, the Pandyas, the Western Gangas and the Rashtrakutas attacked the Pallava kingdom. Dantivarman, Nandivarman the third, Drupatunga were the other rulers who ruled till the end of 9th century CE. Aparajita Varman was the last Pallava king. During his time, the Chola king Aditya the first defeated Aparajita Varman and seized the Kanchi region. Thus, the Pallavas lost their dynasty, and in the ruins of the Pallava dynasty, a new dynasty was born, that is Chola dynasty. With this discussion, we may have an idea about the political history of the Pallavas, who played an important role since the beginning of 4th century, and later they played a dominant role from the middle of 6th century. Besides political development, equal attention was made for the promotion of culture. Their contribution to administration, society, economy, development of religion, literature, art and architecture is immense and everlasting. Regarding the Pallava polity, the Pallavas had a well-organized administrative system. They assumed the title Dharma Maharaja, means they ruled the country according to the tenets laid down in the Dharma Shastras. The king was the head of the state, the fountain head of honor, judge and leader of the armed forces. The Pallava state was divided into kottams and administered by officers appointed by the king. The village is the basic unit of administration and it was run by various local autonomous assemblies. Sabha, Urar were the most popular assemblies of the period. The important feature of the Satavahana polity is entrusting the administration of smaller territorial to an assembly. It is the important feature of them. Regarding their contribution to religion, Buddhism and Jainism lost the royal patronage and mass support in the beginning of 6th century itself. Most of the Pallava kings were the followers of both Vaishnavism and Shaivism. Thus, Hinduism gained momentum during the reign of Pallavas. They assumed the title Maharaja and also performed the Vedic sacrifices. The worship of gods Brahma, Vishnu and Shiva was getting popular. Particularly from 7th century onwards, the Nayanars and Alvars contributed to the growth of Shaivism and Vaishnavism. This came to be known as Bhakti movement. The cult of Bhakti movement began to dominate the religious life of South India from this period onwards. The Vedic tradition was further reinforced by a movement started by Shankaracharya. Shankaracharya also belongs to the same period. Shankaracharya achieved fame by advocating Advaita philosophy. Regarding their contribution to education and literature, it is known that Kanchi emerged a seat of learning and intellectualism. It is the fact that the founder of the Kadamba dynasty, Mayura Sharman, Dharmapala, the rector of the ancient Nalanda University, were belonged to Kanchi and they studied here. The Ghatikas and the Matas, which were attached to the temples, were also promoted the traditional education during this period. With the contribution of the kings, Sanskrit became the recognized medium of instruction in all educational institutions. Besides promotion of education, several Sanskrit works were also produced. Among the important works, the Kiratarjuniyam of Bharavi, Dashakumara Charita of Dandi, Matta Vilasa Prahasana of Mahendra Varman are important. Besides the Sanskrit literature, the Tamil literature had also developed under the patronage of Pallavas. Among the Tamil poets, Thiruvalluvar, the author of Koral, was living during this period. Perundevanar, he translated the Sanskrit Mahabharata into Tamil. Due to the development of Bhakti movement, the Thevaram, composed by the Nayanars, and Nalayara Divya Prabandham, composed by the Alvas, represent the religious literature of the period. The important thing is, the Tamil devotional saints exploited music and dance to realize the concept of compassionate God. This became familiar in the performance of temple rituals and festivals in South India. Another important contribution made by the Pallavas to Indian culture is in the field of art and architecture. The religious revival of the period gave an impetus to the architectural activity. Their contribution to the Indian art architecture is immense and everlasting. Particularly, the Dravidian style of Indian architecture began with the Pallavas. It is a gradual evolution, starting from the cave temples to the monolithic radhas and culminated in structural temples. The five radhas, popularly called as Pancha Pandava radhas at Mahabalipuram, signifies five different styles of architecture. The Kailasanatha temple at Kanchi and the Shore temple at Mahabalipuram remain the finest examples of early structural temples. The Kailasanatha temple, particularly, it is a greatest structural masterpiece of Pallava art. They also contributed to the development of sculpture. The sculpture depicting the descent of Ganges at Mahabalipuram is a masterpiece of classical art. They also contributed for the development of music and painting. The paintings at the caves of Sittanavasal belongs to the Pallava period. Above all, the crowning achievement of the Pallavas was that they became the torchbearers of Hindu culture in Southeast Asia. This later on paved the way for the creation of Greater India. Have a look at the glory and grandeur of the Shore Temple, Mahabalipuram, the Pancha Pandava Radhas of the same place, artistic beauty of the Kailasanatha Temple Kanchi and its sculptural representation. It is an important sculpture depicted on monolithic rock. The scenes of descent of Ganges were carved with marvelous elevation. This one is the Sittanavasal cave, and the paintings, have a look at the Sittanavasal cave and beautiful paintings in it. So, with this discussion on the Pallavas, I hope you may have an idea and understood who are the Pallavas, their early history, their political achievements, important rulers, and their contribution to administration, religion, literature, art, architecture, and painting. Besides the Pallavas, in the same period as a contemporary of the Pallavas, the another dynasty which rose to prominence in the south, particularly in western part of Deccan in Karnataka, are the Chalukyas. Now, we may move to discuss the another topic, the Chalukyas of Badami, who played an important role both in political as well as cultural history of Deccan in particular and India in general. For the Chalukyas of Badami also, we have an interesting history about their origin and background. It became one of the important topic of discussion among the historians. The Chalukyas of Badami were the successors of Vakatakas in Western Deccan. They ruled an extensive area in Deccan from 543 to 753 CE for nearly 210 years. Later on, they branched off into several independent ruling houses. This period has also important in the history of India for their cultural contribution, though they have much importance in the political and cultural history. The origin of the Chalukyas is not clear and it is a subject of controversy. The literary works are full of legends about their origin, and they mentioned different types of accounts about their background. According to Belhana, the original home of the Chalukyas was Ayodhya. Regarding the political history of the Chalukyas of Badami, it is known that Pulakesin the first was the founder of the dynasty, who rose to importance in 543 AD. He was the son of Ranaraga and grandson of Jayasimha. He built a strong fortress at Vatapi, modern Badami, in Bijapur district of Karnataka, and declared independence by performing a horse sacrifice in the year 543 AD. It is a new beginning in the history of Deccan. As a founder of this Chalukyan dynasty, Pulakesin the first assumed the titles like Satyasreya, means Asylum of Truth, and Ranavikrama, the great valorous in war. He was succeeded by Kirtivarman the first, who ruled in between 566 to 597. He also enlarged the kingdom by waging wars against the Kadambas of Banavasi, the Nalas of Bastar, and Mauryas of Konkan. Particularly, the conquest of Konkan brought the important port of Goa, known at that time as Revatidipa, which helped a lot for the growing of the Chalukyan Empire. Kirtivarman the first was followed by Mangalesa. At the Kirtivarman's death, his son Pulakesin the second was too young to rule, so his uncle Mangalesa held sway as regent. Mangalesa also continued the policy of expansion and invaded the territory of Kalachuri king Budraja and extended over Gujarat, Khandesh, and Malwa. Thus, the Badami Chalukyan kingdom expanded over Maharashtra and up to Gujarat region. Mangalesa did not hand over the kingdom to Pulakesin the first when he became age, but wanted to grab it permanently. Because of that, Pulakesin the second gathered his loyal friends and army and defeated and killed his uncle Mangalesa and proclaimed himself as the king in 609 CE. It is known in the political history that Pulakesin the second was the greatest ruler of Chalukyas of Badami and also great ruler of India. He ruled in between 609 to 640 CE. He is credited with many achievements. Let us know about the achievements of Pulakesin the second and his greatness. Pulakesin the second's accession to the throne marks the beginning of an important epoch. The Aihole inscription, composed by Ravikirti, his court poet, narrates his victories and campaigns. From this inscription, it is known that he conducted successful victories against the Kadambas of Banavasi, Alupas, and Gangas of Mysore. The Mauryas of North Konkan reduced to submission. The Latas, Malwas, and Gujras also offered submission. He defeated the rulers of Kosala, Vishnukundins, Kalinga, Vistapura, and Banas. With this, the Chalukyan territories extended over a major portion of Deccan between three seas. Later on, due to the vastness of his empire, Pulakesin the second made his brother Vishnuvardhana as a viceroy of Vengi. Further, he allowed him to rule independently. Thus, a new line of Chalukyas started in eastern Deccan with Vengi as their capital. Besides these victories, the notable achievement of the Pulakesin II, which brought immense name and fame in the history of India, is his victory over the great Harsha on the banks of the river Narmada. With this victory, Narmada became a boundary between these two dynasties. Pulakesin II also conducted successful expedition over the Pallava king Mahendra Varma and occupied the northern portions of the Pallava kingdom. But in the second invasion, the Pallava king lost his life in the hands of another Pallava king, Narasimha the second. Thus, his rule came to an end with this tragic situation. Regarding his achievements, Pulakesin II sent an embassy to the Persian king Khusru II in 625 CE. The reception given to the Persian mission is depicted in Ajanta cave paintings number 1. The Chinese pilgrim Huizhang also paid a visit to the Chalukyan kingdom, and he was highly impressed by the power and efficiency of the administration of Pulakesin II. Thus, Pulakesin II, with his achievements, became one of the greatest personalities of India. He was followed by Vikramaditya the First. There was a temporary decline in the fortunes of the Chalukyas after Pulakesin II because they lost some territories to the Pallavas. The Vikramaditya, during his time, he was able to re-establish the glory by driving out the Pallava forces. He advanced against the Kanchi and defeated the then Pallava ruler Mahendravarman II. Vikramaditya I, with this victory, avenged his father's defeat in the hands of the Pallavas. He also humbled the power of the Cholas, Pandyas and the Keralas. He was followed by Vinayaditya. He was also won many wars, including his war against the Yashovarman of Kanauj. Vijayaditya, he defeated the Pallava king during his reign, Parameswara Varman. Vikramaditya II was the another king who ruled in between 732 to 744. He also waged several wars, including the Arabs in Gujarat, and he defeated the Pallava king Nandivarman II, Cholas, Pandyas, Kalabras, and erected a victory pillar. Kirtivarman II was the last representative of this dynasty. When he came to the throne, already the Chalukyas of Badami were in declining position. The Pallava-Chalukyan conflict, which continued for nearly 200 years, it reduced the economic stability of the Chalukyan kingdom. This in turn gave a blow to the political unity of their kingdom. Taking advantage of that declining, many subordinates started asserting power, and hence the central authority was reduced. Kirtivarman was defeated by Dantidurga, the founder of the Rashtrakuta dynasty, in 753 CE. Thus, the Chalukyas disappeared from the political scenario of Deccan. Later, their kingdom was occupied by the Rashtrakutas. So far, we discussed about the political history of the Chalukyas of Badami, starting with the interesting details about their origin, the important rulers, and the achievements and conquests of the great Chalukyan ruler Pulakesin II, and extension of their territorial limits and consolidation of their power. Besides the consolidation of their power, equal attention was made for the promotion of Indian culture. Their contribution to Indian culture in the fields of administration, society, economy, religion, literature, and art and architecture is immense. Now, let us know about what is their contribution to Indian culture, how they became an important in the annals of Indian culture. Regarding the administration, the central government under the Chalukyas of Badami exercised a paternalistic control over the village administration, which was unlike the administrative practice of South India. Thus, the main difference between the Chalukyan administration and South Indian rulers like Pallavas and Cholas was that they allowed a great amount of autonomy to the village administration, whereas the village autonomy was absent under the Chalukyas. The Chalukyas of Badami, though they are in the middle of the Deccan, it is said to be that they have a great maritime power, and also they maintain a strong army. The army of the Chalukyas consisted of standing as well as feudal levies. Regarding their contribution to religion, the contribution of Chalukyas in the field of religion is everlasting, because the period was an era of revival of Hindu culture and spirituality. The Vaishnavism, Shaivism, Shakta cults, and Jainism had received generous encouragement both from the kings, queens, and subjects. But the Chalukyas of Badami gave importance to the Vedic rites and rituals. It is known that the founding member of the dynasty, Pulakesin I, first performed Ashwamedha sacrifice. The popularity of the Brahmanism and the Puranic religion gave momentum to the building of temples in honor of both Vishnu, Shiva and other gods. They showed admirable spirit of tolerance towards the other religions also. The Chinese pilgrim Huizong mentioned about the decline of Buddhism in Western Deccan during the time of Chalukyas. However, the decline of Buddhism paved the way for the rise of Jainism. Jainism was steadily on the path of progress under the patronage of these rulers. It is known that Ravikirti, the court poet of Pulakeshin II, was Jain. Vijayaditya and Vikramaditya gave liberal donations to the Jaina monks and scholars. The last but not the least one is their contribution in the field of art and architecture. In the field of art and architecture, they laid a foundation for the development of new style of art and architecture. They were the great patrons of art and architecture. The early Chalukyas were responsible for the introduction of a new style of architecture known the Chalukyan style or the Vesara style in the annals of Deccan architecture. The monuments built under this style represent a harmonious combination of Nagara, that is North Indian, and Dravida, South Indian style of architectures. The Chalukyan monuments represent two faces. The first face consisting of rock cut caves excavated at Badami, Aihole and other places. These rock cut caves are monolithic and excavated in slopy hills. They are Brahminical dedication and Buddhistic style and technique. The structural temples built by the Chalukyan kings and their subordinates represent the second phase. The temples were built in large numbers at Badami, Mahakota, Pattadakal, Aihole, Alampur and other places. Among these, Aihole is a town of temples and contains around 70 structures of artistic eminence. Pattadakal is also a complex of temples. Nearly 10 temples are constructed there. Among the temples of Aihole, the Durga temple is in horseshoe shaped platform, which was an imitation of Buddhistic Chaitya. Thus, it is known that Buddhist Chaitya became a model for the rock cut caves of the Badami Chalukyas. However, the Virupaksha temple Pattadakal was built on the model of the Kailasanatha temple Kanchi. The Chalukyas engaged the sculptures brought from Kanchi for the construction of the Virupaksha temple Pattadakal, and the Virupaksha temple was also built on the model of Kailasanatha temple Kanchi. Regarding the style and technique of the cave temples, have a look at the cave's structure at Badami and interior architectural decorations in it. This will give an idea about the caves and art and architecture of the age. The Durga temple at Aihole, it is one of the marvelous structural temple which was built on the model of Buddhistic Chaitya, and have a look at the interior art and architecture of the Durga temple and Garbhagriha. Have a look at the beauty of the Sangameswara temple Pattadakal, and also Mallikarjuna and Kashi Vishwanatha temples of the same place, which are a marvelous art pieces of the Chalukyan period. Besides these temples, the sculptures separating various aspects of Shiva and Vishnu in Chalukyan temples exhibit high degree of perfection in art of carving. The Chalukyan kings not only took interest in building temples, but also took sufficient interest in extending patronage for the promotion of art of painting. Paintings found in cave number 1 at Ajanta represent the Persian Emperor Khusru and his queen Shirin, and Pulakeshin II receiving the return embassy from Persia. Thus, the Chalukyas of Badami played an important role in the political history of South India in particular and India in general. Besides political history, their contribution, particularly in the fields of religion, art, architectural, were sumptuous and substantial. Regarding the paintings of the Chalukyas of Badami, we have beautiful examples at Ajanta cave number 1. Have a look at Mahajataka face and also Padmapani and Vajrapani Ajanta Caves. With this discussion in this module, you have an idea about two important South Indian kingdoms that rose to prominence in the same period as a contemporaries in different parts of South India. Though they are the contemporaries, for nearly 200 years they played an important role in the political history. Both the dynasties came into conflict for the domination over the fertile tracts. Besides that, both the dynasties contributed a lot for the promotion of Indian culture in the fields of religion, literature, art and architecture. It is a fact that the Pallavas and Badami Chalukyas inaugurated a new styles of art and architecture in its history. Thus, with this discussion, I hope you may understood the political history of the Pallavas and their contribution to Indian culture, the political history of the Badami Chalukyas and their contribution to Indian culture. For further, you go through the e-text for better understanding. Thank you.